The big red machine, Kane, had his sight set on eliminating me from WWE in 2008. The monstrous 7-foot-tall behemoth took pleasure in mocking my pain and misery. Kane thought he could use his mind games to break me, but I wasn't gonna let that happen. It's tough keeping your head in the game when facing someone so sick and sadistic, but at Cyber Sunday, where the WWE Universe would choose our match stipulation, the fans chose no holds barred. I didn't know what type of strategy I was gonna bring to the table that night. My technique has always been aerial maneuvers. Was I gonna be able to get away with it at an no-holds-barred match? I made a promise to myself that I wasn't going to show fear. How do I take the big man down? Hit him with whatever I got. I was gonna meet him head on, regardless of the match type, and show him that you can't break Rey Mysterio.
Thank you.
I guess trying to get him with the stop sign wasn't the correct thing to do, because that really got him angry. There's a huge size difference between Kane and me. Kane was always the big red machine. When there's no rules, there's nothing stopping him. The places his mind goes to dish out the violence that he does, that's gotta be deep and dark. It's crazy. This was still early in the match, and Kane already had me in big trouble. Anytime he hits you, takes you out. I wasn't sure that was gonna work, but I knew if it did, it'd buy me some time. Lucky for me, it did work out. And then, of course, I managed to get Kane set up perfectly. But Kane had other plans for me. Now this move I love. In the back of my head, I knew that Kane had more left in the tank. But I was gonna try to do anything I could to try to pin him and win. Definitely a little let down that he kicked out. But I just had to stay focused and on top of him. Like taking the risk and my chances if I wanted to bring him down. But sometimes the risk just doesn't pay off. Kane saw me coming and I suffer the consequences. In these types of matches, you can hear the crowd buzzing a little and then you know something next is coming. You can even hear the commentator saying, "No, what's he doing? No!" You're just trying to get up to your feet, not knowing what's about to hit you. Here it is, when Kane wraps his hands around your throat, you're thinking you're going up for a choke slam. I remember doing everything I could to hook him and put him into the stairs with a drop toe hold. Here's where I took all my chances. It was now or never. I had to put Kane away. And I was going to empty my tank if I needed to. I figured if I got out of the first choke slam, I'm pretty sure I can do it again. And I did everything I could to get out of it. Once I hit the 619 and the springboard splash, it was over. Now, I had too much at heart to let the fans down. They were the ones that chose this match. They wanted a no DQ match. Here it is. And what a true honor to beat WWE legend like Kane and a Hall of Famer. I mean, I have to admit, Kane is special, but an evil special.